As everyone sat around the table, the past, present, and future were coming together for one elusive moment.
Pretty good Christmas. Mommy's mashed potatoes aren't nearly as good as this.
Fate was kind playing that particular Muzak just then.
Excuse me, Madison. Might I steal this man away from you?
Oh, yeah? Yeah.
Sam and Charlotte relished in the closeness brought on by the time well spent on the trip not yet taken.
For you, babe, I couldn't find the door, couldn't even see the floor. I'd be sad and blue. Not for you.
Eleanor let go of her past enough to be in the present. Instead of trying to present the perfect picture, Hank celebrated this moment unphotoshopped.
Wait for the morning light.
Hank and Ruby took their first step on the right foot.
But it would not be new.
All the more meaningful because Bucky had led them to it.
If not for you, a sky would fall, rain would gather too. Without your love, I'd be nowhere at all. I'd be lost if not for you, and you know it's true.
Charlie would always remember his first kiss, his sloppy, awkward, but very first kiss.
You look pretty, Emma. Do you want to dance?
I wish I would love to dance. I would really love to dance.
Emma finally recognized she was already part of a large family. As Bucky stood taking them in, his family unaware of him, this thought entered his head, which he shared with a large Haitian orderly.
Such a fuss. When everything we want is right in front of us, the whole time.
And at last, everyone appreciated that very sentiment. Why is it they can never remember that? Well, maybe the point is, even just for a moment, they do.